Good morning, Eagle Nation. Today is Friday, the 7th of October. Please join me for a moment of silence. Thank you. And now, your Friday song.
Yo, VIP. Let's kick it.
Ice, baby.
All right, stop. Collaborate and
listen.
I sit back with my brand new invention. Something grabs a hold of me tightly. Fold like a harpoon daily and nightly. I don't know, turn off the lights, and I blow. To the extreme, I rock a mic like a vandal. Light up a stage and wax a chump like a candle. Dance!
That's right, Eagle Nation, it's Friday. We've come this far. It is the 47th day of school. 47th day of school. Think about that. One quarter has nearly gone by. But we got a big job to do today. So I encourage all of you to keep the train on the tracks. Stay focused. Do your best work today and get to the very end of it safely, first and foremost. But also, diligently, get your work done today so you can be proud and enjoy a well-deserved break. Wherever you may be, please stop. Please stand. Let's rise together for this morning's Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated. And today, as you know, is a day of rest. We first rest our bodies, and then at 1:35, and thereafter, we rest our minds. So, let's get there together. Looking ahead, I want you to be aware of a couple of things. Of course, football games and practices will resume after the break. Our volleyball team did win its last game, and the tournament at games will continue after the break, so more to come. Also coming up after the break, on October the 20th, which is a Thursday, we have a 5th and 6th grade kickball game between me and Mr. Abiles and me and some 5th and 6th graders. We'll see how that goes, and we'll see you at recess. And for you 7th and 8th graders, we have a dance planned from 4 to 5 p.m. on that same day. It's October the 20th. Yes, it's the 20th. That afternoon from 4 to 5 with DJ Ruben, who will be joining us. We hope that you come. We hope that you're there. And let's have some fun together. Then, on the 21st in the morning, will be our annual Halloween parade. We are inviting pre-K through 6th grade to participate. 7th and 8th grade will have your dance the night before. And so 7th and 8th graders, you'll be invited to come and watch the parade. But we are including 5th and 6th with the parade this year because of our launching of the multi-age classroom, which includes grade 4, 5, and 6 together. So we invite you to. You're not required to participate. You're not required to dress up. But if you decide to do so, just remember you'll keep those accessories at home. So no toy guns and no toy knives and toy weapons, etc. All that stuff's got to stay at home. You'll be able to wear your masks for the duration of the parade. If you need special shoes or sandals for the duration of the parade, that will, of course, be fine. And then afterwards, we'll ask you to put on some shoes to protect your toes and to remove your masks so we can see you for the rest of the day. Then, on the 22nd, is a huge health fair. We're inviting the entire district to come here to Emerson School for a variety of health needs, and there will be games, there will be prizes, etc. Lots of stuff going on that day, and that'll be from 9 to 2 on that day, which is a Saturday. Then, not for the entire district necessarily, but that same afternoon, from 4 until 6, we will have, 4:30 till 6, excuse me, 4:30 to 6, trunk or treat. We invite you to tell your parents about it. We invite you to bring a candy or a game, and it's like tailgating for kids. You pull your car into the parking lot, you turn around backwards, and you play a game like bag toss or pin the tail on the pumpkin. And you get candy for it, you get to dress up. It's a lot of fun. We hope to see you there. And then, after that, 6 p.m., we're actually going to have our first movie night here, Movie on the Lawn in the main courtyard. We hope you come for that. We have not announced the movie yet, so stay tuned for more. But lots of stuff to look forward to after the break. October the 26th will be picture day, so start getting your best outfits picked out or whatever hairstyle you want to have for October the 26th. That's only 21 days away, so lots to look forward to after the break. Just be ready for all of it. And remember, of course, to participate in all of those events. We expect you to be respectful and responsible and caring. If you happen to have an ODR and you're serving your consequence at a time when one of those things is going on, you won't be able to participate. And that would be disappointing, and we would miss you. But it's that important to us that you are always respectful, always responsible, and always caring. So be your best self today, and let's get on with it. Now some words of wisdom so you can get to the teaching of business and the business of teaching and learning. But first, we have our last trivia question for today. And I thought I'd make this one the humdinger. So the first question on Wednesday was worth 5 points. The second question on Tuesday was worth 10 points. If you haven't participated yet, that's okay. This next one is worth 30 points. That means even if you didn't participate on Wednesday or Thursday, or maybe you got it wrong on Wednesday or Thursday, if others get it wrong today, but you get it right, you still could win. Your class could win. So my question, though, is, of course, the toughest one that I've saved it for last. So you got to tell me two parts. First, in your best version, as concise as possible, this was the very first question we kicked off the celebration for. What is the difference between being Hispanic and being Latino? What's the difference between those two terms, Hispanic and Latino? And this is a wide open question, and there's lots of interpretation, so you have lots of opportunity to go right here. If you haven't watched the video, could be a good place to start. And the video is below this one. Good luck to you. Remember that you also need to submit the coordinates on the coordinate grid that correspond with that video. So good luck to you all as we close out Hispanic Heritage Month and look forward to Native American or American Indian Heritage Month coming up after the break. We'll see you then. All right, on the topic today is success in school and commitment. How many of you are familiar with the word diligent? To be diligent means to make a steady effort to get something done. If you're a diligent person, you pay attention. You work hard. You take special care when you're working on an assignment or a job. Did you know that most people who are successful aren't just lucky? They've been diligent. People like Olympic gold medal skater Sarah Hughes, she didn't get just lucky on the ice. She was diligent. She paid attention to her coach. She worked hard. Benjamin Franklin said it this way: diligence is the mother of good luck. So today, remember this. Diligence gives birth to good luck. If you want to create a little luck in your life, pay attention, do your best today and every day. This is Mr. Lodato. Mask up today. Enjoy this song dedication from Ms. Millett. That's going to bring us all closer to the break. It's Walking on Sunshine. It's to all of our students and staff. May you walk on sunshine all the way to fall break. Thank you, Ms. Millett, for your song dedication. Hats off. Hoods indoors. Hats and hoods off indoors. Stay in your zone. Put away your phones. Make it a great day. Or not. Choice is yours.